We're discussing about therapeutic drug monitoring. We have some chapters remaining here, and I told you that most of the template on which we are discussing about the therapeutic drug monitoring of one drug, one class we discussed, cardiovascular disease, the same template we're going to follow for the remaining diseases. Okay. So it's not, it won't take much time for me to complete this. Only main chapter that is remaining from this therapeutic drug monitoring is PKPD, correlation in drug therapy. Okay. So we'll get back to this. But before that, this is also very important chapter, pharmacogenetics. So we have some very rough or vague understanding about some aspect of it, but in today's class we'll be getting into the detail explanation, detail concept. Okay, Abdul Rahman, are you on? Abdul, are you asking any question? Hamid Gadu. Okay, so can you guys hear me? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Can you see my screen?
No, sir.
You can't see my screen? Okay, so can you now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, Garu, would you like to ask any question? Okay, so we're telling this pharmacogenetics we are going to discuss in detail today about its introduction and mostly the enzymes. What are the enzymes responsible in drug metabolism? Okay, so once we get to know about the enzymes that are involved in drug metabolism, then we'll try to understand and correlate the relationship between genetic part, okay, and how this genetic part influence this enzyme. And because of influence on this enzyme, the polymorphism will happen, and then the metabolism will be affected because these enzymes are responsible in the metabolism. Okay, so I'm going to share my PPT with you now. Okay, can you see my PPT?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay, is it better now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today we'll make this class very brief about the introduction rather than going in detail about everything about drug metabolism and the impact of polymorphism on the metabolism. So let me take you through this. Genetic polymorphism is what? What do you already know about polymorphism? Anyone? Let me explain. You know, poly means what? Poly means many. Okay. Morphism means it's a structure. It's the outer morphology. So when we talk about polymorphism, that means we are talking about many forms of the same thing. Okay, here same thing is enzyme. So we are talking about many forms of the same enzymes. Okay, and we'll see why this happens, why many forms of the same enzymes happens. Okay, and then we'll see because of that many forms of the same enzyme, what effect is on metabolism. Okay, so we'll start from the very beginning, the many forms of the same. Okay, so that is polymorphism. So this is the variation in DNA sequence, and we all know these enzymes are nothing but a proteins. Okay, so and these proteins get synthesized from translation. Okay, and this translation happens as a result of or followed by transcription, which is again from DNA. So The everything, that means all this protein and enzymes, whatever is being synthesized, depends on that DNA. Okay, so that means there is something happening at the DNA level. Something happening at the DNA level that causes this polymorphism in the enzyme level. Okay, so we'll see that. And because of that, ultimately, as I told you, there will be variation in the metabolism enzyme activity, and because of that, there will be alteration in enzyme drug clearance. You know, the drug clearance is dependent on metabolism. If the metabolism is high, clearance is high. So if the metabolism is low, clearance would be
low.
Okay. So and finally, the response, the effect of that drug depends on clearance. Okay, if that means if the metabolism is high, clearance is high, and the response will be less. Okay, if the clearance is low, that is metabolism is low, response will be high because metabolism is low. Okay, no, less. Okay, don't get confused.
Yes, sir.
So here, when you talk about polymorphism, we are talking about one specific type of polymorphism. We are not talking about all kind of polymorphism. We are talking about only one kind of polymorphism, that we call as SNPs. Okay, that is single nucleotide polymorphism. I hope you know the difference. You know the meaning of nucleotide. What is nucleotide? What is nucleoside? Okay, and how the DNA gets formed. Can anyone recap it very quickly? Anyone?
It all depends on
let's
phosphate group. I don't know completely, but I think it depends on the phosphate group binding for the.
Okay. Oh, Sarat. Sorry, Srikant. Can you tell the difference between nucleotide and nucleoside?
Phosphate and the energy moiety something. I'm not sure.
Group.
Okay. Let me tell you. So if you see the structure of these, okay, Gayatri, would you like to tell?
Thymine, cytosine, guanine, and one more comes under nucleotides, sir.
It's not that, okay. They are the types of adenine and purine and pyrimidine. That is going to come in the coming slide. The basic difference, the main difference between nucleotide and nucleoside is the phosphate group. Okay, so all of them will be having sugar moiety, and this nucleotide base. Okay, nucleotide base is nothing. This is ATCG, what we discussed, that these are nucleotide base, and all of them will be having sugar moiety. That is a furan kind of ring. They will be differing. Nucleotide and nucleoside will be differing in terms of P. Okay, phosphate. Nucleotide have phosphate, but nucleoside doesn't. Okay, so that is the main difference. So here, this we'll be discussing here single nucleotide polymorphism, and this nucleotide forms the backbone of the DNA. Okay, so here we'll be looking at the polymorphism in the nucleotide. Okay, and that too at the single. Point. Okay, it's not like the multiple. Like when you read the mutation, if you remember from your biochemistry, you have friendship mutation, you have point mutation, you have many kind of mutation. So here we are talking about single nucleotide polymorphism. Okay, so here are some examples. For example, you have G6PD, also called as glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase enzymes. You have another enzyme and acetyl transferase. Okay, so these are two enzymes, okay, where the role of single nucleotide polymorphism can be seen, and its effect in the drug metabolism can be seen. So if you remember G6PD deficiency anemia, okay, many drugs do depend on this enzyme for metabolism.
Anemia.
Yeah, hemolytic anemia will come. It will come in the coming slide. I will explain that a bit in context of this polymorphism, how it's going to affect. And similarly, do you remember in the last class, in the previous class, I was discussing about slow acetylators, fast acetylators. So this N-acetyl transferase enzyme is that enzyme which is responsible for metabolism, or which is responsible in acetylation metabolism of the drug. Okay, so N-acetyl transferase, this is the enzyme. So now, since we are talking about enzyme, these were the two enzyme, common enzyme that you were knowing already. But there are these cytochrome P450 group of enzyme. We call it as super family. Okay, we call this enzyme as super family because there are lot of enzyme in this. There are lot of smaller or the member of this group. There are so many enzymes. We call it as isoenzymes. Okay, so isoenzymes. Do you remember from your chemistry what does the word iso means? So iso means same.
Similar. Okay.
Similar.
Different forms.
Different form of the same enzyme. Okay. So because of different form, they may end up doing different function. Okay. Here function, when we are talking about metabolism. Okay. Clear? So we need to, now we need to understand in detail about this cytochrome P450. Okay. Because there are so many drugs that depends on this family of enzyme. Okay, that depends on metabolism of this family of enzyme. As I told you, so many drugs and chemical gets metabolized. So some of the there are classification. You go back to your textbook and you see how these enzymes has been categorized. Okay, for example, CYP2 family. If you talk about CYP2 family, cytochrome 2 family. So you have B6, you have C9, you have C19. Okay, so all these are of CYP2 subfamily. Okay, out of that cytochrome 450, all of these are CYP2 family. In that CYP2, you have cytochrome 450, you have CYP2 D6, you have CYP2 C9, you have CYP2 C19. Okay, and if you go in CYP3A, again CYP3A is a family under that cytochrome 450. Again, many drugs depends on this enzyme. So you can see here, though there are many enzymes, but 1, 2, 3, 4, these four are the major enzyme that is responsible for metabolizing the structurally diverse drugs and chemicals. Okay, and these are very extensively studied. Actually, we know a lot about these things, these enzymes. So we know a lot, many drugs that depends on these enzymes for the metabolism. So that means if the patient is having some abnormality at genetic level, because we are talking right now about single nucleotide polymorphism, that can be mirrored in the activity of this enzyme. So if there is any aberrant gene at the DNA level, if there is any abnormality, that can be reflected on this enzyme. There and thereby the effect can be seen on the drug metabolism and thus on the response of the drug. Okay, so and we know that we all are different. When I was talking about individualization of dosage regimen, I told you we all are different. Genetically we all are different, and we cannot predict the same drug to act in the same way as it act in one people. Okay, so we'll also discuss now about concept of allele. You know what is allele?
No, sir.
Allele.
Allele.
No, sir.
So allele, if you read the definition of allele, it says that I'm keeping allele aside now. I'll be talking a little bit about this morphological isomorph, okay, morphologically similar structure. So, we were talking about the same structure, that there can be same structure, but there can be same chemical structure, but morphologically it may be different, okay, and because of that, different it may do different functions. Similarly, at genetic level, when we have some code. We'll discuss that in the coming slide. What is that code? What is that? How does that codon works? So this allele is the structurally same, but phenotypically different. Okay, this genotypically it is same, but the phenotypically it is different, and thereby this does the different function than its respective or its counterpart gene. Okay. So I hope you got the overview of what is allele. So the frequency of this variant allele for drug metabolism enzyme often differs from ethnic groups. That's what I told. Everybody is different. Yes, Binusri?
Sir, is allele, is it a result of mutation?
May not be. Okay, it may not be. Mostly when we talk about allele in our concept, in our discussion, we are talking, it's naturally present in all the all individual. Okay, there can be a allele of the same gene and doing different function. Okay, so allele can be when you talk about till now, whatever we have read in the textbook, like in plus two in the previous years, we discussed the normal allele that is present in our in the human and their function. Okay, but allele can be a result of mutation. Okay, clear?
Okay, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
So this is what I told. If you have the understanding, if we have the knowledge about this drug metabolizing enzyme, the difference in enzyme in different group of patient, then with the help of this knowledge, you can individualize the drug dosing. If you remember, when we had an entire discussion on one chapter, individualization of dosage regimen, and there we discussed a lot about patient factor, okay, their genetic factor. So you can actually decide upon individualizing the dose or the drug by if you have the knowledge about genetic makeup of that patient. Okay, and if you do a good drug therapy selection, you can even predict whether that drug is going to work or not, or whether that drug is going to produce some side effect, or the patient is going to improve or not, just on the basis of that genetic makeup. Okay, so I hope you know what is inter-individual variability and what is intra-individual variability. This was a 2-mark question in your last session, if you remember.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So this pharmacogenetics has elucidated the genetic basis for inter-individual variability. That means inter-individual means we are talking between two person, not the same person. Okay. So because of this pharmacogenetics, there is difference in the response between two or more patients. It's because of this inter-individual variability, and this helps us in optimizing drug therapy that we know. And this is what I was talking in the last slide. It, because of this, it has helped us to predict the toxicity, predict the effect, predict whether the drug is going to work or not, whether the patient is going to experience any kind of adverse drug reaction or not. Okay. And I was talking now genotype and phenotype. Okay. So genotype and phenotype. Genotype means, for example, this is very common example to help you understand what is genotype and phenotype. For example, phenotypically I am same as all of you. Okay. But genotypically I am not same. I hope this statement helps you to understand the difference. Okay, my genotype and your genotype is different, but me and you look very similar. I also have two hands, you also have two hands, two legs, and then morphologically very similar. So phenotypically we are very similar. So here we are, when we do the genotypical analysis, we can identify the DNA chains. Okay, what change is happening and in what specific metabolic pathway. So that based on that changes, you can predict the phenotype. Okay, as I told, phenotypically we are same. Okay, we are same, but still, you know, we are not 100% same. And this 100% same this 100% not being same is because of the difference at genetic level. Are you getting me?
So you said phenotype, yes, based on appearance.
I didn't get you, Rubena.
That phenotype is based on appearance. Like we look alike, so we phenotype alike. Is same.
Yeah, phenotype is same, but still we look alike. We don't look completely same. Right. Hmm. We don't look completely.
But how we'll get to know if genetics are different, even phenotypes will be different.
That's what I'm trying
like
you to
said
explain.
After.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, Rubina, go ahead.
And so you said like if we see for genetic analysis, we'll get to know the phenotypic changes.
Result of that genotypic analysis, you can predict how the phenotype is going to be. For example, do you remember in your plus two, you used to do Mendel's crossover, field plant, and then you used to do XY, and then you used to predict, okay, how the color of this final thing will be. So how you gonna use to predict it based on that genotype? Okay, so when you look at my genotype, based on that, though you might not have looked seen me, you can actually predict how my enzymes in the body gonna work, and how the drug is going to work in me, and how I'm going to respond to that drug, isn't it? So that's a phenotypic characteristics that you are predicting based on your genotypic result. That's what I mean.
Okay.
Sir. Yes, Gayatri, you had raised your hand.
Yes, sir. It was when I heard Rubaina that what you told, that 12th standard textbook Gregor Mendel is that people and XY crossover came to my mind. So just to share that, I raised.
Yeah, fine. Okay, thank you. Okay. So here we can classify the patient on several character, several category based on their metabolizing ability. For example, you can categorize the patient extensive metabolizer, intermediate metabolizer, and poor metabolizer. Okay, so if the enzyme activity in the patient is very high, we will call them as extensive metabolizer. If enzyme activity is kind of intermediate, we will tell them intermediate metabolizer. If enzyme activity is very low, we'll call poor metabolizer. And this is nothing new. Okay, I have already explained